Hello, my name is Keshwani.
That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani.
In this video, we'll deal with problems having to do with multiplications and divisions of decimals. Altogether, we'll do 20 problems. In this video, we'll do 10 of them. And in the next video, we'll do 11 through 20, hence 1 of 2. Let's get going. Multiplication and divisions of
decimals. Here's number one. 7.53, we are told, times 0.4.
Well, what we'll find is that multiplying two decimals is no different than multiplying whole numbers. Treat this as 753. We'll worry about the decimal at the very end. Don't worry about the decimal right now. And 0.4, just treat that as a whole number, 4. Let's just multiply. 4 3s are 12, we get 2, carry 1. 5 4s are 20, plus 1 is 21. 1, carry 2. 7 4s are 28, plus 2 is 30. Now that we have done that part, now we go back and figure out where the decimal should go. And that will depend on how many decimals we have here. In this one, 7.53, we have 2 decimals. Here, 0.4, we have 1 decimal. So we're going to pick up our decimal point, which is sitting right here, and move it 3 places. 1, 2, and 3. Voila. The answer to this problem is 3.012. Which makes sense, of course, because if this is 0.4, this is 0.4. Had it been 0.5, half of 7 is 3.5. So the correct answer, whatever it is, gotta be little under 3.5. This is right there. Number 2. And that's very important to realize it, because that will help you figure, understand where the decimal is in the right place. It's not 30, it's not 300, it's not 0.3. It's got to be around 3, because, as I said, half of 7 is 3.5. You have to be aware of it. You have to be cognizant of it, so that you don't end up putting your decimal place in the wrong spot. You understand? Because the answer choices are all going to be the same numbers with the decimal place moved. Do you understand? Here's the next one. It says, find the volume of a rectangular box that is 12.7 centimeter by 6 centimeter by 4.2 centimeters. 4.2 centimeters. Let's see what we can do. You're done with this problem, I'm going to erase it. So again, we're going to deal with whole numbers first. Let's take care of this number, 12.7, and this one first, because multiplying it by 6 is easy. We can do that at the end. Let's take care of the nasty part first. So we have 127 times 42. I'm going to do that first. So here we go. 7 4s are 14, 4, carry 1, 2 2s are 4, plus 1 is 5. And 2 1s are 2. Now we do times 4, hold the unit place, and since times 2 is this amount, times 4 is going to be twice as much. Twice of 254 is going to be 508. Verify it. Let's verify it. 4 times 4 7s are 8. Carry 2. 4 2s are 8, plus 2 is 10. 0. Carry 1. And 4 ones are 4 plus 1. 508, of course. Twice of 254. 2 times 250 is 500, and 54 will give you 508. You get 4, 13, carry 1, 3, and we get a 5. I'm going to erase this part here. And we get a 5. So, what was it here? It was 4.2. So that takes care of these two parts. Now we multiply it by 6. 24, 4, carry 2, 3, 6 are 18, plus 2 is 20, 0, carry 2, 18 plus 2 is 20, 0, carry 2, 6, 5 are 30, plus 2 is 32. And now we go back and see what happens to the decimal place. It's just going to be two decimal places, because this is 4.2. 4.2 has one decimal place. And 12.7 is one decimal place. So we'll pick our decimal place up here from here.
I move it two spots, 1 and 2. Voila. The answer is 320. Answer is 320.04. The volume is 320.04.
Now, here's what I want you to understand. There is a reason why I took so much time to do this problem. Here's what I want you to understand. I'm assuming that you are watching this video because you're preparing for, you're about to sit for either the GRE or the GMAT or TEES or SE or SAT or SAT, one of these six exams. And all of these exams happen to be multiple choice questions with minor exceptions. Do you understand? You with me so far? And since they are multiple choice exams for the most part, the answer choices are sitting right in front of you. When they ask you, what is the volume of this box? They're not asking you, what is the volume of this box? They're not asking you that. They're simply asking you, can you recognize among the five answer choices that are sitting in front of you, can you recognize which one is the right answer? Which is a very different question. As long as you're able to estimate, as long as you're able to come up with a good estimate, you don't have to do all this mumbo jumbo. This takes a lot of time. You don't have to do the mumbo jumbo. Let's estimate, shall we? Here's what we're going to do. We're going to estimate. I'm going to pretend this 12.7, I'm going to pretend it's 12.5 times 6 times 4. Are you with me? So we're going to estimate now. Watch what happens. 4 times 6 is 24. 4 times 6 is 24. We have the 24. Now we're going to multiply by 12.5. Let's do it up here. 24 times 12.5. Are you with me? Watch what happens, okay? 12 times 4. Stay with me in the story. It's very important that you stay with the story. 12. I'm not going to multiply it by 2 and by 1 because we're not babies. Do you understand? We're going to multiply it by 12. 12 fours are 48. 8, carry 4. 12 twos are 24. 24 plus 4 is 28. Are you with me so far in the story? We have just so far we have multiplied 24 by 12. But we were supposed to multiply 24 by 12.5. So this quantity that you see there represents 12 times 24. Now we have to do half times 24. Half times 24. I need the room. I'm going to erase this part. So this quantity, 288, is 12 times 24, as I already explained. Now we have to do half times 24. Half times 24 is just 12. And what do you suppose we're going to get here? 8 and 2 is going to give us 0, carry 1. We're going to get about 300. Not about 300, we're going to get 300. As long as you are able to recognize that the answer is about 300, as long as you are able to recognize that the answer is about 300, that's all you need. That's all you need. Because if the answer choice, if they're moving the decimal places, assuming that they're moving the decimal places, which in question like this, in most of the time, that's all they're doing here. So one answer is going to be 32.004, one answer is going to be 3200.4. So if they're moving the decimal places, then this much work is enough. You know the answer is around 300. Another thing that you have to keep in mind, is you have to always ask yourself, are we underestimating or are we overestimating? That's important to know. In the event that the answers are a little bit close to each other, if they give you more than one answer choice in the 300 range, then you have to know whether you're looking for something more than 300 or something less than 300. So here, are we overestimating or are we underestimating? You have to be cognizant of it. Let's find out, shall we? You see, in reality it was 12.7. We are pretending that it is 12.5. So right there we are underestimating. In reality it is 4.2. We are assuming that it is 4. We are underestimating here, we are underestimating here. If you were underestimating in one instance and overestimating in the other instance, then some of it will be negated. Here nothing is going to be negated. We are underestimating, which is why we came up with precise answer of 320.04. Rough estimation gave us 300. But as I told you before, in most cases, this work that we just did here is plenty. This work will suffice. This much work, in most cases, will suffice. Do you understand? Let's do number three. I'm looking at my list here of S words. Most of you probably do not need this much help in vocabulary, but I'm doing it for the benefit of those who do know, those of you who do need. So far, there we go. Day number 71. Vocab day 71. In most cases, this much work will suffice. Suffice is the verb of sufficient. This much work will be sufficient. It will suffice. Number three, enough of the word. Oh, here we go. I want to play with some, I want to play with you. So I want to do something with you. Listen to me. If you had to do this problem, I'm going to erase all of this thing. This is it. This is the problem. 4.2 times 12.7 times 6. If you had to figure out, if you had to do this calculation, in the form of fractions and mixed numbers, not decimal, will you be able to do this same problem in the form of fractions and still come up with this precise answer? Not an estimation, but a precise answer, exact answer. Something to think about, isn't it? If I have the time at the end of the video, at the end of it, after we finish the 10 problems, and if I remember it, we'll do it together. Do you understand? We'll do the same problem again, but instead of decimal, we'll do it in fractions. Okay? And if you want to try it yourself first, you can do that, obviously. Number three. I'm going to pick up speed now. Number three. Pause the video and do it yourself. As soon as I write the problem on the blackboard, pause the video and do it yourself any which way you want. It's up to you. Any which way you want is up to you. Do it right now. Pause the video and let's do it together. Here's what the question is asking. We have 0.036. I don't know why I'm 0.03. It says 0.36 divided by 1.2. Very first thing you want to do, and it's very important, that your work is neat. The neat work will make it easier and quicker. It's very important that you line up your digits. Now, as you can see, we have a 2 here underneath the 3, but in 6 we have nothing. So put a 0 there. Put a 0 there to remind yourself there is nothing there. Why? Why? I'll tell you why in a second. Because now we're going to multiply top and bottom by 100. By 100? Why 100? Because we want to make this whole number. We don't want to deal with 0.36, we want this whole number. And 0.36 times 100, if you have 0.36 times 100, it moves two places, 1 and 2. It becomes 36. What's going to happen at the bottom? This is where you have to pay attention, which is why I put this 0 in the red ink so you can see it. It becomes 1.2 times the 10 is 12. 1.2 times the 10 is 12. 1.2 times 100 times 100, 1.2 times 100 is going to become 120. Which I'm going to write as 12 times 10. If you find numbers that are multiple of tens, listen carefully. When you're trying to convert decimals into fractions, when you're doing calculation with decimals, not fractions rather. When you're doing the calculations with decimal, or not just decimal, any place at all in any calculation, if you find quantities that happen to be multiples of 10, listen one more time very carefully, if they happen to be multiples of 10, don't squander them, leave them alone, they're very useful, do not squander them. And what I mean by squandering them is, do not put that as 120, leave it alone, that will be very useful in a second, you'll see. Okay, here we go. 36 is a multiple of 12, we have a 12 at the bottom, let's divide top and bottom by 12. And voila, it becomes 3. And now you will see the value of leaving this 10 alone, because now we can immediately see it is simply 3 over 10, which is 0.3. Do you understand? Just leave it alone, don't squander it. Let's do number 4. Number 4. I'm taking too much time on the vocabulary part here, but if I can find it very quickly, day number 37. Vocab, day 37. Again, if you're interested in learning it, just type in vocabulary words, day 37, and learn it. Squander, to waste. So that's it. That was the answer. The answer is 3/10. If they're looking for the answer in terms of fractions, then it's 3/10 or 0.3. Number 4. 0.72 divided by 0.015. Do it yourself. Pause the video immediately and do it yourself. See what you can find. So 0.72 over
0, 1, 5. As I said, line up your decimals properly, line up your digits properly. As you can see here, we have three spots after the decimal. Here we have two. So put a 0 there so that we can hold it there. We can see it there. On the top, you can immediately see on the top, we're going to get a quantity which is going to be a multiple of 10. We're going to get a quantity which is going to be a multiple of 10. So now we are all set. We have to move it three spaces. We have to move this decimal three spots, which means we need to multiply top and bottom by 1,000. If we multiply top and bottom by 1,000, it'll become a whole number. So here on the top, we'll end up at 720. But we're not going to write 720. We're not going to write 720 as 720. We don't want to squander out multiples of 10. We're going to write that as 72 times 10. Leave it alone like this. And at the bottom, we get 15. Let's begin our story, shall we? Let's begin our story. I see a 10, I see a 15. Let's divide top and bottom by 5. 10 will become 2 and 5 will become 3. 72. Do you recognize it? 72, 72. If you look at the sum of the digits, S-U-M, sum of the digits of 72, so sum is 7 plus 2, which is 9. Since 9 is divisible by 3, that tells us that 72 is divisible by 3. 72 is evenly divisible by 3. How many 3's does 7 have? 7 has 2 3's. 7 has 2 3's. After we take away 2 3's from the 7, 2 3's are 6. After we take away 6 from the 7, the remaining one goes and joins the 2 and becomes 12. And 12 has 6 3's. And that's not what I have in my work here. I don't know why I have... Yes, in my work the answer is wrong. In my work I put down 26. It is 24 rather, not 20. Oh, we're dividing by 3. Blast it, we're not dividing by 2. See, that's why I didn't like it here. I didn't want to squeeze it down here. I was distracted because of the fact that I was doing it way down there. Let's do it up here where there is room. So we have this quantity right here, which becomes 72 times 10 over 15. I'm going to start again, okay? Let's divide top and bottom by 3. 15 divided by 3 is 5. 7 has 2 3's. 7 has 2 3's. After we take away 2 3's from the 7, we have a remainder of 1. 1 goes and joins the 2, becomes 12, and 12 has 4 3's. Which makes perfect sense, because if you're dividing it by 3, it has to be 24, because 75 divided by 3 is exactly 25. 75 divided by 3 is exactly 25. Since 72 happens to be exactly 3 less than 75, it should have 24 3's. If 75 has 25 3's, then 72, which is 3 less than 75, must have 24 3's. Of course. Now let's divide top and bottom by 5. 5 is going to go away and 10 becomes 2. And voila. The final answer to this question is 48. The final answer is 48. Number 5. I don't like to make things crowded, you understand? Number 5 says, again, as soon as I write it, pause the video. 0.027 divided by 0.36. You know what to do now. 0.027 over 0.36. As you can see, bottom only has two digits. So we're going to insert a zero here to remind ourselves that by the time we multiply top and bottom by a given quantity, and of course it has to be the same quantity on top and bottom. We cannot multiply the top by 1,000 and bottom by only 100. That won't do. We have to multiply. We're taking this quantity and multiplying it by 1. 1,000 over 1,000 is 1. Which is why it's okay to do that, because we're not changing any value. We're just multiplying it by 1. It's just that 1 happens to be incognito. But it is 1, so we're not changing anything. And now, this 0 here in the red ink will remind us that this quantity is going to be some multiple of 10. 0.36 times 1,000 is actually going to become 360, which we're going to write as, in the bottom, as 36 times 10. Because 0.36 times 100 would have been exactly 36. You see? 0.36 times 100 would have been exactly 36. And therefore, 0.36 times 1000 is going to be 360, which is why we put a 0 here to remind ourselves. So it's 36 times 10, and the top we have 27. This is very simple. This is very simple. Let's divide top and bottom by 3. 27 has 9 3, this 3 has 1 3, and 6 has 2 3s. I see 12 and a 9. Let's divide top and bottom by 3 one more time. We end up with 3 and a 4. So 4 times 10, we end up, final answer is 348. Final answer is 3 over 40. I know I have told you several times in the past as to when we learned about incognito. And I'm going to tell you one more time. And I'm going to tell you every time we come across a vocab word. Day 42. Again, type in vocabulary words, day 42, it will pop right up. And if it doesn't come up, put in my name also. Just type in Keshwani, vocabulary words, day 42, and it will pop right up. I want to digress a little bit. What does it mean to digress? It means to change subject, to go off topic. We learned about digress long time ago in our vocabulary lessons. Long time ago. Digress, I believe, was on day number 3. Very early in the game we learned it. Vocab day 3. Digress is a verb. The noun of digress would be digression, of course. Let's digress. Here's my question. If you were to ask to represent 3 over 40, either in decimal or percentage, will you be able to do that? If they were asked you to convert, if they give you this quantity and tell you, convert this quantity, convert this fraction into either a decimal or a percentage, will you be able to do it very quickly, fast? It's very simple. Whether you want to convert a given fraction into a decimal or a percentage, listen very carefully. The trick here is to convert the bottom number to a 100 or something as close to 100 as possible. Convert the bottom number to 100 or something as close to 100 as possible. For example, if they ask you how much is 7/9, how much is 7/9 in decimal, convert the bottom number into 100 or something as close to 100 as possible. So multiply both quantity, top and bottom, by 11 over 11. Now 9 times 11 is 99, so we end up with 77 over 99. That tells us that this fraction here is approximately 77%. What can we multiply 40 by to turn it into a 100 or something close to 100? But it turns out that we have a nice quantity which will convert 40 into exactly 100, which is 2.5. 2.5 times 40 is exactly 100. Why? Because 40 times 2 is 80, and half of 40 is 20. It's going to be exactly 100. So now the bottom is already converted into 100. Do the same thing to the top, and we're done. The answer is 3 times 2 is 6, and 3 times half is 3 halves over 100, which is same as 3 halves is same as 1.5, which is going to become 7.5 over 100. So if they ask you in decimal, answer is it is, or if they ask you this quantity in percentage, 3/40 is 7.5%, because it's over 100, or 0.075 in decimal. So it's right here, exactly, 3/40 is equal to 0.075 in decimal. Not 0.75, 0.75 would be 75%. We want 7.5%, not 75%. So it's 0.075, this quantity. Of course, because 3 over 4 is 75, 0.75. 3 over 4 is 0.75, since 3 over 40, we have to put one more decimal spot. What number was this question? I know I digress too much. What number was this question? Number 5, I believe. Number 6. 7.3 times 6.5. 7.3 times 6.5. Again, you can estimate it if you want to. You can estimate it. It's very simple. It's not that complicated to estimate it. You can estimate it, or you can even find a precise calculation. Let's do estimation, quick calculation, estimation. 7 times 6.5, because in the exam, in most cases, you can get away with it. Answer choices are far apart, as I always remind you. Answer choices are quite far apart. And if they are not, if the answer choices are not far apart, then you do the extra work if you have to. Do you understand?
7 times 6 is 42. And 7 times half is 7 halves. 7 halves is 3.5. So it's 42 plus 3.5. The approximate answer is going to be about 45.5.
Are we underestimating or are we overestimating? This is an underestimation. Correct answer, whatever it is going to be something a little bit more than 45.5, because we took 7. In reality, it's 7.3. Do you understand?
Now let's do the exact calculation. Let's do the exact calculation here. So, 73 times 65 times 65.
Let's get going.
3 5s are 15, 5 carry 1, 7 5s are 35, plus 1 is 36. Hold the space for unit digit. 6 3s are 18, 8 carry 1. 7 6 are 42, or plus 1 is 43. 5 14, carry 1, 7, I'm getting, so now we do our decimal spot. Now, we do our decimal spot and see what we get. It was 7.3, one spot here, 6.5, one spot there, so we have to move it two spots. Decimal is sitting right here. Decimal is sitting right here, pick it up and move it two spots, 1 and 2. The final answer is 47.45. We came up with 45.5. In reality, it's about 47.5. But in most cases, you should be able to spot the right answer, because as I said, they're going to be a little bit away, far away. Not far away, but a little bit away. Do you understand? Now, purely out of curiosity, and I have not done this thing ahead of time, so I'm going to do it with you here. Question is, will you be able to do this work on your own in fraction form instead of decimal form very quickly? Let's find out, shall we? So it's 7.3, which is 7 3/10. Are you able to see it? 7.3 is 7 3/10 times 6.5. Okay, watch what happens. I may have to erase this thing because it's going to be in our way, so I'm going to erase it. Keep in mind that the answer was 47.45. I'm going to put it up here. I'm going to erase this thing, because I don't want to make it too crowded. And we want to get that answer. Let's see what happens, shall we? Let's see. I'm curious. 7 times 6 is 42, plus 7 times half is 7 over 2. 7 times 6, or rather, 3 tenths times 6. Leave it like this. Don't try to do it in your head. We'll do it in a second. And then finally, we have 3 tenths times a half. Let's see what happens. Okay, we'll find out. We'll see what happens. But the first thing I'm going to... Well, this is also half. So this is 3.5. This is 3.5. This is 3.5. And this is 42. This is 45.5 so far. And let's see what this gives us. 45.5. Tell you what, I'm going to do all the fractions together. So this is 18, this is 18 over 10, this is 3 over 20, so I'm going to make this into 20 as well. So this is 36 plus 3 is 39 over 20, oh, this is turning into a real freak show. This is turning into a horrible show. I should have gone there. Since we started, we have to finish it. And this half, I'm going to write that as, half can be written as 1 over 2, but we don't want 2, we want 20 at the bottom, so put this as 10 over 20. Okay, here we go. So one more time. This 7 halves was 3.5. This is 3.5, I'm writing as 10 over 20. This is 18 over 10. 18 over 10, multiply top and bottom by 2, it becomes 36 over 20. 36 over 20. This is 10 over 20. And this is 3 over 20. 10 plus 36 is 46, 46 plus 3 is 49.
it is 49 over 20, which is same as 40 over 20, which is 9 over 20. So we get another 2. You see here we had 45 already. We get another 2, that gives us 47 and 9 20th. 47 and 9 20th. 9 10th. 9 10th would have been 0.9. And therefore, 9 over 10 would have been 0.9. 9 20th, therefore, is not going to be 0.9, but half of 0.9, which is 0.45, which is what we have here. You see that? But this was a freak show just for the hell of it. No other reason. Do not do this in the real exam. Do not do that at all. Do you understand? This is just to improve your math skills, just to improve your skills. It doesn't hurt. It doesn't hurt to exercise. That's all it is. Think of this as a big event. If somebody is training for a marathon, of course you want to exert your body, you want to exercise to get better prepared, even though you know that in real exam, you're not going to come across it. You're not going to do it. Let's do number 7. It says divide, I need the room. .03 into .072. What does it mean, divide .03 into .072? It's very important to understand language. And if you want, if it helps you, make up whole numbers and see what happens. Divide 3 into 72. What do you suppose they meant by that? If they say divide 3 into 72, what are they asking here? When they say divide 3 into 72, here they are asking us how many 3's does 72 have? How many 3's does 72 have? And how do we find it? We simply take 72 and divide by 3, which is exactly what we're going to do here. Instead of 72, we have 0.072. We have 0.072 over 3. That's what we have to find out. So I'm going to write this in a little bit cleaner handwriting. Watch what happens. I'm going to rewrite it as 3. This is 3. And now we're going to write this as, we're going to write our 3 as, not 3, but we're going to line up all the decimals. 1, 2, 3. You see that? And see what happens. So now we're going to multiply top and bottom by 1,000. Top and bottom by 1,000. That's it. Now we'll have a whole numbers. 0.072, since we're multiplying it by 1,000, 1, 2, 3, we're going to move the 3 decimals by 3 spots. 1, 2, 3, it becomes 72. That was the whole point. 72 over 3 times 1,000 is 3,000, but we're not going to write that as 3,000. We're going to write that as 3 times 1,000. Keep your multiples of 10 separate, as I said before. Let's divide 72 by 3, which is all we were going to do before. How many 3's does 7 has? 7 has 2 3's. 7 has 2 3's, 2 3's are 6. After we take away 6 from the 7, the remaining one goes and joins to 2, becomes 12, and 12 has 4 3's. 3 goes away, and we end up with 24 over 1,000. 24 over 1,000. If they want this thing in decimals, if they want the answer in decimals, then we are done. If they want it in fractions, we'll do more work. So let's first do the decimal part. Let's first do the decimal part. 24 over 100 would have been 0.24. It's not 24 over 100. It's 24 over 1,000. So instead of 0.24, it is going to be 0.024. That's it. That's your answer in decimal, if they want it in decimal. If they want the answer in fraction, then we'll do more work. This is not the answer I have in my book here. 24 over 1,000 This is not the answer I have in my notebook. Something has gone wrong. Oh, blast it. We are not dividing it by 3. This is wrong. It says divide 0.03 into this thing. It doesn't say divide. What we found out is how many 3's. What we found out is what is 0.072 divided by 3. Which is why the final answer was less than what we started out with, because we are dividing it by 3. That's not what it says. It says divide this quantity. Divide 0.03 into 0.07. Let me redo it. It's not 3, it is 0.03. We're going to have to start again. .03 divided by .3. So we do what we always do, which is line up the decimal and put one spot here. Multiply top and bottom by 1000. Multiply top and bottom by 1000. What happens? This is going to become 30. This is going to become 30, which is on the top we get 72, on the bottom we're going to get 30, which we can write as 3 times 10 divide 72 by 3. 7 has how many 3s? 7 has 2 3s, 2 3s are 6, the remaining one goes and joins 12, joins 2 and becomes 12, and 12 has 4 3s. You end up at 24 over 10, and if they want the answer in decimal, then we are done. The answer in decimal is 2.4. If they want the answer in fraction, then we have to reduce it more. 24 over 10 is simply 12 over 5, which is going to be 2 and 2 fifth, and of course 2 and 2 fifth, the 2 fifth part is the 0.4. Understand? I wasn't paying attention. Number 8. I don't like to do the editing in the videos. I just make one continuous video, however it comes out with all the mistakes in it. And because I make one continuous video, I had two choices at that point when I found out that I made a mistake in number 7. One choice was to just fix my mistake and keep on going, which is what I'm doing right now, or to retape the whole thing from the problem number 1. I didn't want to do that. Number 8. Besides, this I believe is more natural, because you can see how people can be so careless. Number 8. 0.4. Oh, this is a multiplication one. This is very simple. This is actually very simple. 0.4 times 0.16. Well, this is very simple, because we know 16 times 4, we know is 64. It's 64. So instead of 16 times 4, we don't have 16 times 4. We have 0.16. We have two spots. 0.16, 1 and 2 times 0.4. One spot. So two spots here, 1, 2, and one spot here. That's 3. The decimal is sitting right here. Move it 3 spots to the left. 1, 2, and 3 is going to move here, and we need to insert a 0 here. The answer is, and always put a leading 0 before the decimal just for emphasis, point, this 0 right here, 0.64. Always put a leading 0 before the decimal. For emphasis, it makes it easy to see that it has a decimal there. Number nine, the penultimate problem. 0.6 divided by 0.03. 0.6 divided by 0.6. By now, of course, you're used to it. 0.6 divided by 0.03. It has two spots, so we can insert an artificial 0 here. A 0 that actually doesn't belong there. Well, it does belong there, but one does not write it. 0.6 is 0.6. One does not write it as 0.60. We are writing it for emphasis to remind ourselves that it's going to be a multiple of 10. So multiply top and bottom by 100, and 0.6 times 100 becomes a 60, which you can write as 10 times 6, and the bottom we have 3. There we go, we're done. The answer is 50. That was very straightforward, very simple. It's 50 or 20. My note says 20. If you divide by 3, how many 3s does 6 have? 6 has 2 3s, not 5. What the hell is the matter with me? The very last one, number 10. .006 divided by .063. Again, do it yourself. Pause the video and do it yourself. 0.007 over .063. You have two decimal places at the bottom, so insert a third one. Now we have three decimal places, top and bottom. So we can take this quantity and multiply it by 1000 over 1000. We are essentially multiplying it by 1. We have not changed anything. 0.007 divided times 1000 is just 7. And at the bottom we're going to get 63 times 10. Divide top and bottom by 7. 63 has 97, and we end up with 1/90. The answer is 1/90. That's it. That was number 10. Now, if you like, and only for those of you, who are going to be able to brook it, I want to go back and redo question number 2 in fraction form. Remember, question number 2 was like this. Question number 2 was, find the volume of something that was 12.7 times 6 times 4.2. Let's do this thing, not in decimal, but with fractions. As I said, this is only for those of you who can brook it. And again, I'm going to tell you very quickly when we learned the word brook. If you are able to brook it, stay with me. If not, then you have suffered enough. You may be excused. Day number 4. Vocabulary, day 4. That's it. Watch the video and learn it. Just type in vocabulary words, day number 4, and learn the word brook. So this is only for those people who are able to brook it. So 0.7 is 7/10 times 6 times 0.2 is 1/5. Okay, let's begin. Let's begin and see what happens. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to write, first we're going to take care of this and that, worry about 6 later, okay? So we're going to do these two quantities here. So here we go. Watch what happens. 12 times 4, let's do it here. 12 times 4 is 48. Stay with me, this story is very important. 12 times a fifth is going to be 12/5. Are you with me? Let's erase this top part so we don't have to deal with it, because we don't need it. There. 12 times a 5 is 12/5. That part is done. Now we do 4 times 7/10. 4 times 7/10. 4 times 7/10. And finally we do 7/10 times 1/5. Remember, the point here is that we have to come up with a precise answer in fraction form. And the precise answer was this. If you remember it, it was 320.04. That was the precise answer. Let's see what we can do. Let's just carry on, okay? So, let's divide top and bottom by 2. This is going to become 2 and this is going to become 5. So here we have 12/5, 12/5. And here we have 7 times 2, which is 14/5. Are you with me so far? Leave this alone for the time being. We're going to keep this thing in abeyance. For the time being, let's leave this quantity in abeyance. Let's just concentrate on this and this. 12 plus 14. 10 plus 10 is 20, and then 26. So this is 26 over 5. Are you still with me? 26 over 5, which can be written as 12 plus 14 is 26, which I'm going to write that as 25 plus a 1 over 5. And 25 over 5 is just 5 plus a 5th. Are you with me? I need the room, so I'm going to erase all of this thing and I'm going to just write down as 5 plus a 5th. This quantity is 5 plus a 5th. It's 5 plus a 5th. So we have 48. Here we have 48 plus a 5 plus a 5th. I hope you're still with me. And now we're going to bring this down here. And that was 7 over 50. 7 over 50. Ah, very good. So this is very easy. 48 plus a 5 is just 53. So that part is done. We have to worry about these two parts.
Let's see what happens. Okay, let's just watch what happens. Here we have a 50, here we have a 5. So I'm going to multiply top and bottom by 10. I'm going to multiply top and bottom by 10. And we're done. We're done. The answer is 53. And 10 plus 7 is 17. 17 50th. That's the answer. Now we have to multiply it by 6. Now we have to multiply this quantity by 6. Because remember, there was a 6 in the middle. There was a 6 in the middle, which we had not dealt with yet. So let's take this quantity and multiply it by 6. What does it mean to keep something in abeyance? Again, see, when we were working with these two quantities, I told you, let's just leave this in abeyance. We'll deal with it later. We dealt with it here. For the time being, we left it alone. We left it in abeyance. Again, I'm digressing. There are too many vocabulary words in this video, so I don't know why. Only in the event that you are motivated and you want to learn. Good vocabulary is a must. Regardless of which test you're preparing for, whether it's GRE, GMAT, SAT, SAT, SE, T, it doesn't matter. Day number 9. Just type in vocabulary words, day 9. Okay, so we're done with it. It's 53 and 17th 50. 53 and 17th 50 multiplied by 6. Are you with me? Let's do it here. I'm going to erase all this thing because we need the room. We need the room. And see what happens. Keep your fingers crossed. Let's hope and pray to God that we actually get what we want. So, 6 threes are 18, 8, carry 1. 6 fives are 30, plus 1 is 31. Plus what? Plus 6 times 17 is 50. 6 times 17 is 50. Are you with me? How much is 6 times 17? Oh, don't look at me. How the hell do I know? 6 times 17 is what I'm looking for. 6 times 10 I know is 60. Are you with me? And 6 times 7 is 42. It's going to give us 102. Now, you understand that if I were doing it myself, I wouldn't be stupid enough, I wouldn't be silly enough to actually waste my time writing on the side here. I'm doing it for your benefit so that you're able to see what's going through what I'm thinking here. But you can see, you can just look at it and figure out, instead of having to do it out, you can just look at it and figure it out. It's 60 plus 42. 6 times 10 is 60. 6 times 7 is 42. It's 60 plus 42 is 102. So it's 102. Again, I wouldn't have written it down if I were doing it myself. I'm doing it for your benefit. It's 102 over 50, which can be viewed as 100 over 50 plus 2 over 50. Are you with me so far? 100 over 50 is just 2. 100 over 50 is just 2. And 2 over 50 can be viewed as, I'm going to put it in red ink so you can see that, 100 over 50 can be viewed as, multiply top and bottom by 2. Multiply top and bottom by 2. But either 2 over 50, not 100 over 50, 2 over 50 can be viewed as 4 over 100, of course. 2 over 50 is same as 4 over 100. 4 over 100, if you reduce it, it becomes 20 over... 4 over 100, if you reduce it, it becomes 20 over 50. And 4 over 100 is just 0.04. So here we have a 2, and here we have 318. 318 plus 2 is 320.04. What do you know? That was the end of the freak show. Do you understand? The freak show is what you were looking for on the YouTube. You have come to the right place. This is even better than a freak show because this is freak show with the accent. Bye now.